White House bash at 11:05. Before that, a little later than billed, the quiz show that'll drive you to distraction with some strong language and nudity.
Welcome to Distraction, the show where we distract people as we force them to answer questions, a bit like the American troops in Iraq. Saddam Hussein is being handed over to the Iraqi people, and the Iraqi's new foreign minister has promised him a fair and unbiased trial, followed by an execution on July the 1st. So he's pretty confident about the result, then. I think it's all been a tragic mistake. When they said Saddam had the A-bomb, I think they meant to say he had a bomb. Two rifles and half a box of ammunition. Of course, we're helping America in Iraq, just like they helped us in World War II, except we didn't turn up 2 years late and then claim all the glory. They say people argue just so as they can make up again. Call me cynical, I don't think that's what's going on in the Middle East. Suicide attacks are on the increase, and something needs to be done. I personally think what Baghdad needs is a branch of the Samaritans. Sure, some of the bombers are genuine, but most of them are just cries for help. They just need to talk to someone. Well, I need to talk to someone now, so let's meet tonight's contestants. Right, Emma, Damon, Nina and Mark, lovely to have you here to play Distraction.
Thank you. Thank
Before you. We start the show, I thought I might ask you a couple of questions about your fellow contestants to get to know you a little bit better first. Damon, who here used to work at the famous Ibiza sex fetish nightclub, Manumission?
That will be Mark.
You think Mark?
Yes, I know.
You know it's Mark?
I know it's Mark. I've been there.
Well, you're absolutely right. It is Mark. And what did you do there, Mark?
I did a variety of things. I did end up doing the sex show.
What exactly did that entail? Some sexy dancing, was it?
I used to give myself a blowjob on the stage.
I think a round of applause, yeah. Any chance of a demo this evening?
I might be a bit nervous, you know.
You can have a go on mine. Out of interest, when you were working at Manumission, sucking yourself off...
Yeah.
How much did you get paid a night?
About 12 quid.
What would you do for £15? Did you spit or swallow?
Smeared it all over my face.
It looks like Nina and Emma are no strangers to that. Is it not a strange thing to be, you know, a heterosexual guy sucking a cock?
It's my own cock, though.
It's your own cock?
Yeah. Can you suck your cock?
Well, no, but that's why we've got runners on the team. Well, I'm very glad you've come out this evening, Mark, because, quite frankly, if I could suck my own cock, I wouldn't leave the house. Bless you. OK, one final question for you, Mark. Who here has done a naked skydive?
I'll say Nina.
Well, the one that gave it away by laughing?
Probably.
Excellent guest. Nina, it was you, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
Tell me the story. What happened?
There was a guy on the back of me. He was naked as well, and so was I, and we just jumped out of plane.
There was a guy on the back of you? What if there was an accident? You would have been buggered. Was everyone else in the plane naked?
No, there was just me and him. Just me and him, and then the driver, but he was dressed.
The driver? I like to call them pilots. Now, you do body painting.
Yay!
Right, Nina, what's that?
Body painting. We paint up naked people and we paint them as if they're wearing something. I'm actually painted today. No, I'm not really, I'm dressed, but...
That was just your little joke there.
No, yeah. Really laugh. No, so, yeah.
Could you paint me?
I probably could, yeah.
No, you fucking couldn't.
I would.
Tell us the story about the massage job you got in Australia.
I actually went for a job as a lingerie waitress.
So you order some lingerie and they bring it to you?
Nope. I walk around in lingerie serving champagne and food.
Well, not like that. You spill it.
Got to the place and this little old Chinese man walks in with a dressing gown on and says, unfortunately, the restaurant's not open at the moment, but we do have another job. We do sexual massages. He took his kit off, lay down there, and I gave him a full body massage and a body-to-body massage.
Did it have a happy ending?
He tried to have it to have a happy ending, but I did actually say no then, and I did walk out. I can give sexual massages now, so...
I imagine I could as well. There's nothing tricky about that, is there? It's Mark. Mark's got the real skill. Last question, Nina. Who out of Emma and Damon claims to have seen a ghost?
Emma.
It is Emma. Emma, tell me the story. What happened?
Well, when I was little, I saw, well, what I thought was my granddad on my granny's stairs. And I explained his pyjamas and everything, and he died before I was born, so there was no way I would have known what pyjamas he had.
So you were in your grandmother's house?
Yeah, I was going up the stairs.
And you saw an old man
yeah.
in pyjamas, and you thought that must be a ghost. Yeah. There's no way my nana could be getting a portion off an old fella.
She was a good Catholic lady. You ruined my childhood illusion.
Yeah, yeah, I have. If there's any theme with this show, that's pretty much it. That's the ghost story out the window. Just an old bloke your nana was fucking. Oh. Okay, what do you do for a living?
Well, at the moment, I ultrasound pregnant tummies.
Ever found anything in there other than a baby?
Sometimes people think there's babies and they're not.
Just trap wind?
Yeah.
That must be difficult. Is it a boy? Is it a girl? It's a fart. So, no need to worry about names. Okay, now you once had to answer a call of nature behind a van. What happened?
I was out with a couple of friends and about halfway through the walk home, it's about 3 o'clock in the morning, we all needed the toilet. So there's this big red van, so we thought, quickly nip behind here, took our jeans down, squatted, and the van drove off. I'm sure the van driver found it quite hilarious.
I imagine he did, yeah. Oh, God bless you. Okay, one final question for you, Emma. Emma, true or false, Damon has stolen a pair of Daniel Bedingfield's pants.
True.
Yes, it is true.
It is true.
Why did you steal his pants?
Because I could.
Where did you steal them from?
I had a job at an airline, looking after VIP customers, and he left his bags behind one day, and the bag got opened somehow.
Was it because you pulled the zip, man?
Yes.
Is that what opened
yes,
it?
Yes, it kind of came undone when I did that.
Oh, right. Sometimes
so,
some bags
it
do
sort
that.
Of fell open.
It's a design flaw.
But I thought, fuck it, I'm going to take them. So I did. So.
Were you one of those people that, you know, when a VIP is flying, you take care of them,
yes.
make sure the general public don't get anywhere near them,
yes.
make sure autograph hunters don't bother them,
yes.
that sort of thing, yeah.
Yes.
I believe you've got a collection of 400 autographs. I'm guessing that's why you don't work there anymore.
Well, yes.
Now, I believe you starred in 2 films.
Yes, I did.
Could you tell me about those films?
I can. One was called A Horny Housebreaker, and one was called Pirates on Parade.
Right, now, I've not seen them. What kind of films are these?
They're porn films.
And what happens? Are you in it with other girls
solo.
Or boys?
It's
or
solo.
Solo?
Solo stuff.
So it's a film of you cracking one out?
Yeah, basically, yeah.
How long is this film?
It's about an hour, I suppose. Right?
An hour?
Well, it was two on one tape. Buy one, get one free.
As if anyone's watching you crack one out and going, I'll tell you what I want to watch now. Him knock another one out. Emma, would you ever be tempted to get a video maybe and stick it on of a guy cracking one out?
Not particularly.
Hang on, Nina probably would.
What about Mark?
Yeah, Mark
doesn't need a video. Nature has given Mark all the entertainment he ever needs. I don't imagine Mark owns a telly. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen, something for everyone. Our contestants. Right, round one is a quickfire, fingers on buzzers round. If you'd like to remove those cloths. In the middle of those cacti, you'll find a buzzer, which you need to press if you think you know the answer to a question. Pressing a buzzer while being stabbed repeatedly, a bit like calling on a friend in Moss Side. I'd imagine. Obviously, I don't have any friends in Moss Side. You don't have to use your hands in this round. You can use your faces or genitals. Mark. The answers to the questions all begin with the letter P for pricks. OK, you ready? First question. Name a fish beginning with P. Mark?
Pike.
Yes, a pike. Whose nose would grow when he told a lie? Nina.
Okay.
Correct. Complete the title of the film. Meet the... Mark.
Parents.
Correct. What P means to have no money? Nina.
Poor.
Correct. Which rapper went out with J-Lo? Mark.
Puff Daddy.
Yes, you could have had P. Diddy. Obviously, you couldn't have had him. Right, let's up the ante. You seem to be getting the hang of that. I think this game would be better if the cactuses were revolving. It would also be better if you were wearing blindfolds, I feel. Stick your blindfolds on. You ready? Which adult magazine was founded by Hugh Hefner? Nina.
Playboy.
Correct. Which member of the royal family was allegedly caught smoking pot? Nina.
Prince William.
No, it was Prince Harry. Complete the saying, up the creek without a... Damon.
Paddle.
Correct. What do Americans tend to call trousers?